gives the Eagles the history. What a football game this could turn out to be. Tell me if you're ready for a party. Let me hear it if you want to win. You know it's time to ball. We about to kick it off. And all y'all let the games begin. Oh, yeah. DC, get ready. Philly, get ready. Are you ready for some football? A Monday night party. Huh. Stay the track. Let's get it kick-started. Yeah. Here's your game face on.
And the crowd's getting signed.
Oh, yeah. All my riding friends are here on Monday night.
Now, this fired-up crowd is definitely ready for some football. They're Eagles winners of four in a row. The best record in football, the only remaining one-loss team, as they welcome Jay Gruden and the Washington Redskins, who enter at 3-2. And as we said a moment ago, critical game, particularly for the Redskins, with an eye on winning the NFC East. Doug Peterson, in his second year, won the toss and deferred. So Jake Elliott will kick it away, and the Redskins and Kirk Cousins will have the ball first. 70 degrees, unusually warm for this time of the year. It was a beautiful weekend here in the city of brotherly love. 10-mile-per-hour wind might be a factor. It is at the back of Jake Elliott as he kicks off. And this important NFC East matchup underway with a touchback. Chris Thompson watched it sail over his head. So here comes Kirk Cousins, completing 66.5% of his passes. Excellent touchdown to interception radio and ratio. And John, you talked about Carson Wentz's running skills. That's a new dimension this year for Kirk Cousins as well.
Yeah, the yardage is impressive, but he's scrambled for 8 first downs already, and he's running the zone read too, Sean, and that's a play that hurt Philadelphia last week against Carolina.
Cousins under center. Rob Kelly is back as the featured back tonight. He's been bothered by an ankle injury of late. And a quality run. He gets 6 on first down. Najee Good made the tackle.
That's an impressive start for Kelly. Young backs, you don't know how they're going to come back from injury. How quick do they recover? How can they play when they're not 100%? And it's important that the Washington Redskins have success running the football on first down, because nobody runs the ball more than Washington on first and 10.
Both of these teams have made a conscious effort to run the ball more this year, and they've done so effectively. Cousins deep down the field and caught. First down and much more. Into Philadelphia territory goes the ageless Vernon Davis, all the way to the 38-yard line of Philadelphia.
Well, Jordan Hicks had a bad ankle coming in here tonight, and they go right after Hicks with Vernon Davis. Hicks fell down, and he's hurt. And Vernon Davis, over 20 yards a catch. The ageless wonder out of Maryland. But the Philadelphia Eagles missing Michael Kendricks tonight, a very good linebacker. He is not active, and now Hicks, who's been in and out of the lineup with this ankle, this is a big injury right now for Philadelphia.
They could be down 2 of their 3 starting linebackers if he cannot continue. There's Jim Schwartz in his second season as defensive coordinator here, the former head coach of the Detroit Lions. Concerned about Jordan Hicks, John mentioned Michael Kendricks coming off a 13-tackle performance in that win a week and a half ago in Carolina. Out tonight with a hamstring injury, and that does not look good for Hicks's possible return tonight.
And Washington has been a fast starting offense. The last 3 weeks, they've gone right down the field with the opening kickoff and scored touchdowns. And that would be huge for them if they could put something on the board, obviously, to start this game.
Meanwhile, the Eagles have not allowed a touchdown in their last 8 games in the first quarter. First down after the 31-yard gain. Rob Kelly stuffed this time after a yard. Tough bunch to run on. The Eagles, the number 1 rushing defense in the NFL, giving up under 66 yards per game rushing. Be a good matchup because the Redskins have one of the best offensive lines in football, led by the Pro Bowlers Trent Williams and Brandon Sheriff. The backs and receivers, Jay Gruden talked about trying to get more targets for Crowder and Dotson. Chris Thompson's been outstanding. He's their leading rusher and receiver. Miles Paul lines up in the backfield as a fullback. Cousins on target again. Jamison Crowder on cue. Inside the 20 and wrestled down to the 17 by Jalen Mills. A 20-yard gain for Washington.
Aggressive play action pass. You go right after Hicks' replacement, Najee Good. He steps up and Crowder fools him. You said it. They got to get Crowder back involved in this offense. He had over 850 yards and 7 touchdowns last season. And I think he's the best all-around wideout on this team.
In his third year out of Duke. There's Chris Thompson. Ducks ahead for a couple. Bo Allen, a backup, part of a deep defensive line for Philadelphia, made the tackle. There's Chris Thompson. The only player in the league leading his team in both rushing and receiving yards.
He's been a game breaker. 340 yards receiving. I think 339 of it is after the catch. He's been magnificent in the open field.
On second and eight, Cousins under duress, throws and throws it away in the direction of Dotson. There's been one consistent problem for Kirk Cousins. As Jay Gruden calls the play, he has not always been excellent here in the red zone.
Tough place to get it done, and you're right. He has got to find ways to get the ball into the end zone, and on third down and eight. This is where Jim Schwartz, the defensive coordinator, has dialed up a lot of all-out blitzes. He had success against Cousins in week one. Will he bring it again?
Deafening noise here at the link. On third down, from just outside the 15. Plenty of time for Cousins. On target to Ryan Grant. He can't get the first down. Excellent tackle along the near sideline by the veteran Patrick Robinson. And it's a field goal situation. And Nick Rose about to attempt his first NFL field goal, signed after a tryout earlier this week. They lost Dustin Hopkins to a hip injury. Rose beat out three other contenders for this job, including the veteran Mike Nugent. He's been banging around for 2 years, hoping that somebody would give him an opportunity. Cut by Atlanta, was in San Francisco this preseason, cut again. Jay Gruden is giving him that chance. From 27 yards, the former Texas Longhorn knocks it right down the middle.
That's a big sigh of relief for Jay Gruden. I was struggling with him.
And a big sigh undoubtedly for Rose as well. Much improved over a year ago. Last season, the touchdown to interception ratio almost even. Low yards per attempt. They finished 7-9 after 3-0 start. They're 5-1 this year. Look at the ratio, 13-3. The yards per attempt up by a yard and a half per attempt. Only Alex Smith of the Chiefs a bigger improvement in that area. And the most important thing, the record, 5-1 for Wentz and the Eagles. Among his many skills, a terrific leader. So Nick Rose will kick off. Good kick into the wind. He has a big leg. And that's about 8 yards deep. Kenyon Barner took a knee. Here's the lineup around Wentz. The offensive line led by the 9-time Pro Bowler, 35-year-old Jason Peters. They get Lane Johnson back at the other tackle after he missed the Carolina game with a concussion. Much better receiving core than a year ago. They went out and brought in free agents Torrey Smith and Alshon Jeffrey. Both have been difference makers, as has been the improvement of third-year receiver Nelson Agholor. Wentz out of the gun on first down. Wendell Smallwood was the running back. Throw on target For a gain out to the 32-yard line, Alshon Jeffrey driven back by Quentin Dunbar. There is a flag down near where the ball was caught. Ed Hockley, the referee tonight.
We're going to get Aguilar with a push-off.
Pass interference offense, number 17. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Repeat first down.
Jeffrey has always had an unorthodox route-running style. And they got him that time at the top of his route for a push-off. I thought it was ticky-tack, but take a look at 17 on the right side of your screen. I see that a lot. Fans don't like that one.
Fans are still upset. They didn't like the officiating in the Eagles win at Carolina. A little extra time to prepare for this one. The Eagles' last game was that win against the Panthers a week ago Thursday. Smallwood back from a knee injury and running well. Another flag thrown near the end of the play. He got to the 28-yard line, about 7 yards short of the first down.
That usually is holding.
Illegal block in the back by the offense, number 86. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Half the distance to the goal. If you first down.
Zach Ertz at the point of attack. That's a good call. Not a great start here for this Eagle offense.
You may see a lot of flags tonight. Ed Hockley's crew has called 20.2 penalties per game this year, most among any officiating crew in the league. Play action pass. Wentz sidestep Ryan Kerrigan. Here's the great scrambling ability that John was talking about. There is another flag down on this play as Wentz goes out of bounds on the near sideline at the 24. Still about 11 yards short of the line to make. And here is another Eagles penalty.
I don't think I've seen this ever.
Holding offense number 65. After this is the goal.
Lane Johnson returning at right tackle. He missed last week with a concussion. He's working against Ryan Kerrigan.
Well, these fans really upset with the officiating. The Eagles won in Charlotte last Thursday night despite the fact that they were penalized 10 times for 126 yards.
Now there's another one.
Panthers were whistled only once for 1 yard. And there's another flag down.
There's 12 in the huddle.
12 men in the huddle. Offense. Half the distance to the goal. Still first down.
Well, they can't argue that call. There are 12 men on the field. There's 12 men on the field. But that was a history-making game in Carolina. It's the first time in NFL history that one team racked up more than 120 penalty yards while the other team finished with less than 10. And a petition went around here in Philadelphia asking the NFL not to schedule Pete Morelli and his crew to any more Eagle games. It is still first down, remarkably. First and 33 from inside the 3-yard line. LeGarrette Blount rejected by the Redskins defensive front. Including Mason Foster, who was questionable tonight with a shoulder injury. They lost the rookie Jonathan Allen to a foot injury for the rest of the year, so Terrell McClain steps in with the front three. Foster is out there. Ryan Kerrigan making his 102nd consecutive start. And a lot of injuries in the secondary. No Josh Norman tonight, the former Pro Bowler, out for the second week in a row with an injury, a rib injury. And starting safety DeShazer Everett is out with a hamstring. Rashad Breeland's playing with a knee that caused him to come out of last week's game against San Francisco. Wentz out of the end zone. Long, wobbly pass that's intercepted by Quentin Dunbar. Intended for Torrey Smith. But that might even be better than a punt for the Redskins with that change in field position.
We had no chance from the very beginning, and there's our grinder filling in for Josh Norman with a big interception to set up Washington.
Fletcher Cox off to a great start this season, including the opener at Washington. He was a game record for the Redskins offense in that Philadelphia win. And it looked like, John, they were ready for him tonight.
Well, first series, watch left guard 77, Sean LaValle. You got to look for work. Those kind of plays allow your quarterback to step up. That's great work by this Redskin line. That's what this rivalry is all about.
Here's Jamison Crowder to the 45-yard line. Malcolm Jenkins on the tackle for Philadelphia. He's the leader of this Eagle defense. Deep up front, we'll see as many as 7 defensive linemen, the starters. We're on your screen. Najee Good in for the injured Michael Kendricks, and now Joe Walker, ordinarily a special teamer, in for the injured Jordan Hicks. And in the secondary, veteran safeties in Jenkins and McLeod. Jalen Mills, an emerging star in his second year at the corner. Rob Kelly dropped for a loss. There's the best run-stopping defense in the NFL. It was Vinnie Curry.
Well, the Redskins were confused. They didn't even come off on the right snap count. Right side of the line is late coming off the ball. A lot of confusion. I don't know what happened here, but they're not going to run the ball against that. One of the reasons the Eagles have the number one rushing defense is nobody rushes the ball against them. 28% of the time opponents have run it against Philadelphia. Got to do better than that. Mm-hmm.
Some of that undoubtedly the fact that the Eagles have played with the lead a lot this year. Here comes a blitz, and Cousins gets hit as he throws. Is it intercepted? No. It's ruled incomplete. The other question would be, was it definitely a forward pass? Nigel Bradham, the blitzing linebacker, got to Kirk Cousins.
It's an all-out blitz. We covered it in the pregame. They bring it in a lot of unpredictable situations. And there is an injury on the right side of the line for the Redskins. Their Pro Bowl right guard, Brandon Sheriff, being looked at on the sidelines. Clearly, the ball hit the ground. But credit Jim Schwartz with the spontaneous all-out blitzes that have driven Kirk Cousins and the Redskins crazy.
Sheriff appears to be okay. Kenyon Barner back for the punt from Tress Way. And Barner signaled fair catch, then got away from it. There is a flag down back near where Way kicked the ball. That was definitely an example of the wind being a factor. It helped knock down that punt. The 44-yard punt. Mock cheer from these Eagle fans as the opponent is penalized.
By the kicking team number 57. So Philadelphia is elected to enforce that from the previous spot. 10 yards, repeat fourth down.
Oh, your long snapper. Nick Sundberg is called for holding. You know they're calling it tight.
So they move the ball back to the 33-yard line. The field position starting to shift a little bit for the Eagles because of all those penalties on their first possession. They were back at their own 3-yard line. They did pick up 54 yards of field position change on the interception thrown by Wentz. Ray's punt fielded by Barner. The former Oregon Duck picks up some blocks. The punter Way slowed him down, and Niles Paul finished him off. Happy to report no flags on the play, and excellent field position now for the Eagles. 44-yard punt, return of 23 for Barner. Dating back to 1934, their meeting on Monday Night Football in September of 1976 was historic. Legendary Redskins coach George Allen earned career victory number 100 against the Eagles and Dick Vermeil. the first meeting of the two teams on Monday Night Football. The Redskins won the game. It went almost 4 hours on a Mark Moseley field goal in overtime. Two legends in that picture. Three nothing Washington. Much better starting field position here for Carson Wentz and the Eagles from their own 45. Play action fake to LeGarrette Blount, and the pass broken up. Quentin Dunbar again with good coverage on the tight end, Brent Celek. And John, let's go back to the play on which Brandon Sheriff was hurt and bring in Jerry Austin, our referee in the booth. Jerry, you think there should have been a penalty here on Barnett?
Clearly that's a penalty. Barnett is a defensive player pursuing the play, and he hits an offensive lineman from behind. That's a personal foul for unnecessary roughness.
Call these penalties and miss that one. That's ridiculous. That's bad officiating, and that's a bad play by Barnett. It's like guys get hurt.
It appeared Sheriff did get hurt. Let's see if he returns. When they're back on the field, Barner stood up by Bashad Breland.
And checking in here, Sean, is Junior Gallette on third down. And Gallette missed the last two seasons with Achilles tendon injuries on both legs. The ex-New Orleans Saint is a man they are waiting for, waiting to come onto the scene and make a big play. And he had 22 sacks his last two seasons in New Orleans. Can he come all the way back from these injuries?
Jay Gruden, Greg Minuski, the defensive coordinator, told us in our meetings last night they think Gallette is getting closer to that form. They see it in practice. Wentz in trouble and sacked back inside the 40-yard line. Ryan Kerrigan leading the way for Washington.
Kerrigan has played his best football against the Philadelphia Eagles. He had 10 sacks in his career coming in here, and they're moving him inside. I have not seen them do this very much. Stefan Wisniewski has been the weak link of the offensive line. They've used three different left guards. Why not put your best pass rusher against Wisniewski? I like those poses he does.
He's a big professional wrestling fan.
Yeah, so am I.
Jamison Crowder back for the punt from Donnie Jones. Crowder will try to return it, and he loses the football. It is free, and it looks like the Redskins got it back. Kamu Grigé-Hill knocked it out. Washington has recovered back at the 7-yard line.
Crowder has had a lot of difficulty hanging on to the football as a punt returner, and Washington dodged a bullet.
Joshua Holsey got it back.
ESPN.
Are you ready?
Next week, we're back in Kansas City at Raucous Arrowhead Stadium. Alex Smith and the Chiefs hosting the Broncos. Classic AFC West rivalry, a big game. 8:15 Eastern time, Monday night countdown at 6. From their own 7, the Redskins come out firing. Cousins on target to Ryan Grant. He's tackled immediately by the rookie out of West Virginia, Rasul Douglas.
This is amazing to me, Sean. Rasul Douglas is a rookie right corner out of West Virginia. There's no way they expected Douglas to be the starter. The nickel corner has been number 21, Patrick Robinson. He's on his fourth team. And at left corner is second-year man Jalen Mills, a seventh-round pick from LSU. These three young men have done an unbelievable job carrying the Eagle defense with all the injuries they've had.
They traded for Ronald Darby from Buffalo, a cornerback in the preseason. He hurt his ankle. Cousins on target. Niles Paul lost the football after he was out of bounds, and another big gainer for Washington. Patrick Robinson with help from Rodney McLeod on the tackle, but the play went to the 42.
That's a gutty call. Running a bootleg to your quarterback's non-throwing shoulder, and Kirk Cousins throws a beautiful strike to Niles Paul, but totally fooled Barnett, the rookie from Tennessee, who lost contain, and that's a huge completion to get Washington out of a backed-up situation.
32-yard gain. They've had gains of 20, 31, and 32 already in this first quarter. Redskins leading 3-0. Rod Kelly, second year man out of Tulane. On an injured ankle. He's also been battling a rib problem. Missed two out of the last three games. Looked healthy there. Credit Chris Long with a tackle. But it's a gain of 8.
The outside zone, the staple of the Redskin offense. And Kelly, a 230-pound back, is a force when he gets north and south. A couple nice runs for Kelly early against this Eagle defense.
Undrafted out of Tulane last year, wound up being the Redskins' leading rusher for the season. 704 yards last year. The Eagles rush 5. Cousins still had time for the pump fake and then an errant throw, closest to Jalen Mills of the Eagles than anybody else.
Here comes Brandon Graham, defensive end, number 55 of the Eagles. They do an unbelievable job here in Philadelphia of keeping this defensive line fresh. They don't play as many snaps as they have played in previous years, but they come in, they're like relievers that come in for one inning and throw fastballs. And they got 7 or 8 very good players that can apply heat.
Yeah, they have 7 defensive linemen who played 150 snaps this year, most in the league, and they're after Cousins, and they get him back at the 42-yard line. Derek Barnett, one of those talented backups, the rookie out of Tennessee, their first-round pick this year.
Very talented player with a great motor and a great get-off. 96, left side of your screen. Mismatch against Jordan Reed. Well, Jordan Reed has just not been himself this year.
Barnett, 33 sacks in Tennessee in 3 years, broke Reggie White's volunteer career sack record. Kenyon Barnett back for the Tressway punt.
Another flag. It's hard to broadcast some of these games.
Well, you're doing a great job.
So are you, Sean.
Despite your frustration. 48-yard punt, 10-yard return.
During the kick, holding by the receiving team number 33. A penalty is enforced from where the kick was caught. Half the distance to the goal, Philadelphia keeps the ball, first down.
Well, it's unusual when Ed Hockley does not have the biggest guns in the building, but
look at that.
That's Deuce Gruden, the son of the legendary John Gruden, himself a legendary.
I'm gonna sick Deuce loose on you, Ed Hockley, if you don't quit calling these flags.
How about those guns? Assistant straight coach for the Redskins.
That's funny.
And the gold medalist in Belarus this summer with his proud family there at the World Powerlifting Championships, the 183-pound weight class division. I'm never going to get into a beef with you because I don't want Deuce coming after me.
No, me neither.
On first down from the 5, Wendell Smallwood just down the road in Wilmington, Delaware. A short gain. Mason Foster made the tackle.
You know, Sean, these rivalry games, I was a part of this series as a coach. I was offensive coordinator for the Eagles, and twice a year you got to play the Redskins. And there's so much tradition. There's so much going on in this rivalry. Not too far apart. Both teams hate each other, and it's hard to beat a team twice in this NFC East. This is going to be a fist fight right here on Broad Street tonight.
So Greg Minuski, the defensive coordinator, played for the Redskins, played in this rivalry. Wendell Smallwood again to the 11-yard line. They'll need 4 on third down. Doug Peterson, former NFL quarterback, 12 years in the league, mostly as a backup, started 17 games. He is the play caller for the Philadelphia Eagles.
And Washington has rebuilt their pass rush, Sean. They lost Jonathan Allen, their first round pick. 72, Anthony Lanier making his debut tonight as an inside pass rusher. Let's see what he has.
We're good. Inactive for the first 5 games this year. The slant, good call by Doug Peterson. The catch by Alshon Jeffrey, and the run gets him to the 24, tripped up by Quentin Dunbar. It's a first down for Philadelphia, gain of 13.
Well, I thought it was a pick play on Trey Burton. I thought Burton ran interference on Quentin Dunbar, but I'm glad there was no call there, Sean.
when you're playing corner and you're playing press coverage, you got to be aware of receivers coming at you to try to pick you off of your man.
The Eagles, the best third down team in the league this year. Another reason for their 5-1 start. They're just over 50%. Wentz has been the best passer in the league on third down. He's surrounded by Redskins and takes off running. Flags down in the secondary. If the run counts, it's another first down just shy of the 35-yard line.
It's in the Redskins secondary. Perhaps multiple fouls.
Joshua Holsey, rookie backup defensive back, heading to the locker room.
On the play, holding number 26. That penalty is declined. There was also a personal foul, face mask, number 47. The penalty is enforced 15 yards from the end of the run. First down.
They got Breland and they got Dunbar. For the face mask. That's a good call. Josh Norman still battling the rib injury, and Jay Gruden told us last night, Sean, he might be back next week. Yes. Against Dallas.
Very close to being ready to go. Still very painful when he sneezes or coughs or yawns. That takes us to the end of the first quarter. Monday Night Football from Philadelphia. Washington. The season opener, 30-17, that ended a five-game winning streak for the Redskins in this rivalry.
Oh yeah.
Some of the great former Eagles introduced Hall of Famers in the Eagles Hall of Fame, including our pal Ron Jaworski.
It's great to see Jaws, especially in Philadelphia.
One of the nicest guys any of us could ever hope to know. First and 10, Philadelphia from just shy of midfield. Playing the penalty at the end of the first quarter resulted in 26 yards for the Eagles. Looked like they grabbed the face mask again, and here comes the flag as Wentz was yanked down by Junior Gillette.
And we can complain about the officials, but at some point you got to let these players know this is ridiculous. Two face masks within 10 seconds. Blocks in the back.
Personal foul, face mask.
Sloppy football.
Defense, number 58. 15 yards from the end of the run. First down.
And Junior Gillette, the man that we talked about earlier, they're waiting for Gillette to make a play, and so far he has just hurt his team big time with a penalty.
The eighth enforced penalty already, just more than a quarter in, so we're on a pace for about 32 of those. But as we've seen on these replays, no question about those face mask penalties. Line of scrimmage to 33. The play fake and the pass incomplete. Trying another quick slant for Alshon Jeffrey. Bashaud Breland in coverage.
Well, these are RPOs, and you see at the last second, Wentz pulls the ball out of the back stomach. He's going to pull the ball out of the back stomach and try to throw a quick bullet slant at the top of the screen. Bang, bang play. But that's this Eagle running game. They have a lot of runs with built-in pass options. And on second down at 10, good to see Wendell Smallwood back as the single back. He's their best blitz protector.
Out for the last two games with a knee injury. Here comes Mason Foster on a blitz, and as Wentz tried to get away, he slipped. And it's a sack for Washington, and that probably takes Philadelphia out of field goal range for the moment. Back at the 43-yard line.
Well, Mason Foster and Zach Brown, two veteran inside linebackers, on a blitz. And you see Brown, number 53. There is not a linebacker in football that can run like Zach Brown. He ran 4-4 at North Carolina, had some interesting years as a Titan and a Buffalo Bill. And here is Carson Wentz on third and long.
You mentioned their effectiveness on third down. 45% on third down or 10 or more. That is astounding. Nelson Aguilar, the juggle, held on to it. He gets blasted out of bounds. Crowd wants a late hit there. No flags coming. And the line, the 32, well shy of the first down. And they'll send the field goal team out with the rookie Jake Elliott.
This game is chippy, just like previous Redskin Eagle games that I remember. And I thought Nicholson was late on arrival. But here's Elliott, who has become quite a hero here in Philadelphia after making that 61-yarder to beat the Giants.
Caleb Sturgis was their kicker at the start of the year. He kicked three field goals in the win against Washington, the opener, but was injured. Elliott has been the kicker ever since, and they love him here in Philadelphia. That's right down Broad Street from 50 yards out. It is a division rivalry game, and it's tied at three. Bad game back in 1998. Redskins players left the game with injuries. Redskins lost both quarterbacks, Jeff Rutledge and Stan Humphries. Running back Brian Mitchell had to play emergency quarterback. Eagles won the game 28-14. Reggie White had two sacks and the first interception of his career. And still remembered very fondly here. He's still the all-time leader in sacks for the Eagles franchise. The Pro Football Hall of Famer at 124 as an Eagle.
He was something. Had a chance to work with him when I was with the Packers, and he had a lot to do with Green Bay turning their team around as well.
The body bag game, Buddy Ryan, the coach of the Eagles, William Frizzell, and the Eagles apparently asked the Washington sideline if they needed body bags over there as their players kept going down, and that's where the body bag game came from. Amu Brije-Hill with the tackle on Chris Thompson's kickoff return. Here comes Kirk Cousins in a 3-3 game.
Well, Philly's coming with a four-man rush, and they're going to bring a lot more. They're going to bring an all-out blitz. And for Kirk Cousins to be the great quarterback and the $100 million man, he's got to recognize this, communicate an audible, and execute against a lot of heat. Philly is going to bring four, and they're going to bring a lot more. You just don't know when.
Starts this possession from under center. And a play action pass. It got Vinnie Curry sucked inside. Might have been a design run for Cousins, because he's much more comfortable this year as a runner. It's more instinctive now, where before he would always have to think about if he was going to run. That time they might have made the decision for him on the play call.
I think it's a play action pass. It's a designed bootleg. He's going to come out to his left. Crowder's in the flat. He didn't think anybody was open. He probably could have flipped it to Dotson, who I thought was wide open on a comeback. But Kirk Cousins has used his legs a lot more this season than in years past.
Picked up the first down. Rob Kelly is the running back. Quick hitter to Josh Dotson. Avoids the tackle and then runs out of bounds after picking up the first down with about 7 yards to spare at the 47.
This man is interesting. First round pick out of TCU, has had Achilles problems for 2 years. This is an RPO, a one-step hitch, and Patrick Robinson, a backup corner, looks bad in the open field. Big receiver, very good after the catch. Touchdown machine at TCU. They need him to step up and replace DeSean Jackson and Pierre Garçon. That was the plan.
Both Jackson and Garçon were 1,000-yard receivers last year. They both left via free agency. The group that is here really has not stepped up. There's a catch in the secondary. Vernon Davis, another big gainer. John Mechet averaging more than 20 yards per catch. That leads all NFL tight ends in yards per catch at 33 years old.
Well, Jay Gruden knows they've got backup linebackers in there, and you saw number 59, Joe Walker, had no idea where that play was going. But Jay Gruden, over the years, has done an excellent job creating vertical passes. He had Tyler Eifert in Cincinnati. They've had Jordan Reed and Vernon Davis, and the former sixth-round overall pick of the 49ers, two-time Pro Bowl receiver. Participant has really made big plays for the Redskins.
And Jay Gruden calls him a freak with the way he takes care of his body. The pitch back to Chris Thompson, who got upended by Jalen Watkins, the corner, at the 17-yard line. Vernon Davis knows he can still run. He says he told Jay Gruden, when I can't run anymore, you tell me, and that's when I will hang it up.
That'll be a while, no doubt, Sean. Good to see Jalen Watkins back as well. He was hurt, missed a few games, and when you can take Chris Thompson down in an open field situation, that's impressive.
Cousins needs to hurry. Play clock at one. They just do get it off. Philadelphia brought a blitz. The throw on target for a first down. Another catch for Jamison Crowder, tackled by the safety Malcolm Jenkins.
That time he saw the all-out blitz. He sees the blitz coming, and he took the game over. Fixed the protection, changed the route. Made a perfect pass. That's a big-time play by Cousins. And I believe it's Morgan Moses, Sean.
It is Morgan Moses, their right tackle. In his fourth season out of the University of Virginia, become a fixture right tackle. Still not getting up. Timeout 10-17 to look like a left ankle injury. TJ Clemmings has come in at right tackle for Washington. 10 minutes to go in the half. 3-3 to score. And the pass is caught, but is it inbounds? Flag down the play, pass incomplete. Intended for Jordan Reed.
Boy, Philadelphia blew that coverage. No one covered Josh Dotson. And Jordan Reed clearly out of bounds, but Josh Dotson against Patrick Robinson was wide open.
By the defense,
Cousins never saw it.
The 5-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Destiny Viau, one of the backups in that Eagles defensive front, called for the penalty.
Boy, you don't get guys open like that often. Washington catches a break with the penalty. First and goal.
Sixth play of the drive for the Redskins. Started from their own 19-yard line. Rob Kelly went down as he tried to avoid Nigel Bradham.
There's not a lot you don't like about Nigel Bradham. He's the playmaker for this defense. He knows when to run through gaps, and he is an excellent tackler. He has a mean streak in him. He plays linebacker like Byron Evans and a lot of the great Philadelphia inside backers they have had here.
Excellent speed for Bradham, the former Buffalo Bill out of Florida State. Jake Gruden singled him out among the Philadelphia defenders for those playing well. Cousins has a man wide open. Thompson will walk into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington.
How do you blow coverages against Chris Thompson? Backup linebackers, Najee Good, number 52. No idea who covers Chris Thompson on this burst route across the formation. Is it Bradham or is it Dude? That's now Washington. That's a man, though, Sean, you probably want to keep your eyes on.
Yes. Leading rusher and receiver coming into tonight's game, Chris Thompson. Battled back from some serious injuries, getting a fractured back at Florida State, and is an emerging star now in the NFL. Extra point good by Nick Rose, his first NFL PAT. 7-yard touchdown pass. Historic pace for Chris Thompson through their first five games. He had 340 receiving yards. Since 1986, that's the third highest receiving yardage total by a running back in the NFL. Only Marshall Faulk and Matt Forte have surpassed that total.
Well, while you're waiting for Josh Reed and Jordan Reed, and you're waiting for Josh Doxson, and you're waiting for Crowder, why not lean on Mr. Thompson?
Yeah. How about that gesture? He got a little attention this week. He's such a nice guy, very unassuming. But he said this week he wouldn't bring his family to Philadelphia because of how rough the fans here can be. So maybe that was an olive branch. Very nice gesture to give the football to a Philadelphia fan.
But, you know, you got to remember what he's been through. With all the injuries, he broke his back at Florida State. ACL injuries. It's great to see guys hang in there and see good things happen to them.
Jay Gruden calls him the best third down back in the league, and he's becoming even more of that. A factor on the earlier downs, too. Rose's kickoff is a touchback. Saturday, 8 Eastern time. Primetime college football action on both ABC and ESPN2. It'll be Georgia Tech taking on number 7 Clemson and Texas Tech squaring off against 10th-ranked Oklahoma. Both games will be on nationally, so check the local listings to see which game is on ABC and which is on ESPN2 in your area. Be on one or the other. Or just turn on the TV. Go to both. Flip back and forth. They're both entertaining games. On 1st and 10 for Philadelphia. Down by a touchdown. LeGarrette Blount in his first year with the Eagles. Chopped down by Preston Smith.
And DJ Swearinger. They run this cutback play with LeGarrette Blount. Sean, you do not want to be the unblocked safety in the box. But when I sit down with DJ Swearinger, he's one of these crazy safeties that actually likes mixing it up with the best big backs in football. What a physical presence he's brought to this Redskin defense.
He's been a difference maker. He was selected as a team captain before he ever played in a regular season game for Washington. Wentz surrounded but got it off. Up for grabs and incomplete. Intended for Alshon Jeffrey. Excellent coverage by Bashaud Breeland.
Excellent coverage. And Breeland, questionable coming in here tonight. Hurt his knee last week against the 49ers. He's in a contract year. He's played good football for the Redskins. Good no call. Third down and long the last time. Washington put Kerrigan on the inside. This time they're going to leave Kerrigan at the top of the screen working against Lane Johnson at right tackle.
Best third down team in the league is just 1 for 3 on third down tonight. They push the pocket right into Wentz, and the pass is batted down again by Bashaud Breeland. Flag down on the play.
Well, Greg Minuski said they're going to bring up the gut pressure and get in this young man's face, and they've done it tonight. And here's Ed Hockley.
Hands to the face, offense number 28. The penalty is declined. Brings up fourth down.
You know, you blitz to get somebody free. You also blitz to get one-on-one for some of your defensive linemen. And when you can push the pocket like Matt Ioannidis has done, you get things done. And Greg Minuski, veteran defensive coordinator, he did it in Indianapolis, he did it in San Francisco and San Diego, and he's really done a nice job for the Redskins.
Back in his home state, he's a native of Pennsylvania. Jamison Crowder has fumbled 3 times this year on punt returns, including earlier in this game. The one tonight was the first one that he did not lose. Minuski busily at work. His defense has been excellent against the 5-1 Eagles. Kirk Cousins playing very well tonight. What has to be an emotional time for him and his family. Last night, his grandmother, Jean Cousins, of Lake Barrington, Illinois, passed away unexpectedly. Kirk Cousins on Instagram mentioning that he will see her again. Deeply religious family. Kirk Cousins' dad, Don, is a pastor. Both of these quarterbacks, men of tremendous faith. Our condolences to the Cousins family. Chris Thompson ran out to the 35-yard line. Kirk Cousins, a very impressive young man, very close to his grandmother. He spent part of the 2013 offseason training in the Chicago area and lived with his grandmother.
I know Kirk Cousins well, Sean. He is a great young man. Mm-hmm. He is coming from great stock. His family, they're very close, and this is a tough time for their entire family. We wish them the best, certainly.
His faith was reinforced when he was in high school. He got injured, thought that would be the end of his chances to play in college. He was not all that heavily recruited. His dad recommended then he lean on his faith and trust in God's plan for him, and it's been quite a plan. Josh Doxson stopped just short of the first down. Matter of fact, Michigan State offered him a scholarship, but they told him it's conditional because we have several other guys that we'd rather have, and if they take him, then you're not getting the scholarship. But he went to Michigan State, one of the all-time great players in the history of the school.
Not a Cinderella story. behind Kirk Cousins. And on third down and one, will it be Kelly? Or will they take a shot against predictable man-to-man coverage?
The Eagles crowding the line of scrimmage. Single safety deep off the line in the flat. The catch made by Reed, but he looks to be short of the first down. Malcolm Jenkins right there for the Eagle defense. And Morgan Moses, who did return to the game for this series for Washington, is injured again.
That's not a good play by Malcolm Jenkins. That's a great play. And you see the former cornerback skills that he has. He took the perfect angle and made a great effort on that play. And concern right now with Morgan Moses, the right tackle, who I think he's starting his 39th straight game tonight.
Well, the start to the season for both of these teams impressive, particularly in light that both have had to deal with a lot of key injuries.
Well, Trent Williams came in here tonight with a bad ankle. He has not practiced in 2 weeks. Knee. Brandon Sheriff left earlier at right guard, and let's see what happened to Moses.
Well, earlier it was his left ankle, it appeared. This was what caused him to leave the game on the last series. See his left ankle.
Boy. That's just unfortunate.
And this was the most recent play. And now it's his right ankle. So he got tangled up with Rob Kelly. Trent Williams playing with a bad left knee. Jay Gruden said last night he might not practice again the rest of the year. Might need a surgical procedure on his kneecap when the year is over. Tress Way with the wind at his back, hoping for a soft bounce and didn't get it. Over the head of Kenyon Barner, 60-yard punt. But it'll come out to the 20. Tonight's Monday Night Lights, focusing on John Bartram High School of Philadelphia's public school league. They are 9-0 heading into the playoffs, led by a dual-threat quarterback, Mahmoud Diabate. Yesterday, the Braves visited the Eagles practice, got a chance to interact with players and coaches. Congratulations to Coach Jim Chapman and the Braves. Good luck in the playoffs. The Braves are here tonight on the field pregame.
Gotta love it.
They love their football here in Philadelphia. They're excited about the 5-1 start for the Eagles. Four-man rush after Wentz. Low throw and a good catch. Didn't look like Smallwood was touched down, so he gets up and alertly runs for the first down.
Let's see if Zach Brown touched him. This could be a review. Yeah, he was touched. The challenge is, Jay's going to challenge that. It's not even close. They might not have to go back to New York for this one, Jerry. Just go up here to us.
Washington is challenging a ruling on the field. The runner was knocked down by contact.
Well, let's bring in Jerry Austin again. What say you on this call, Jerry?
Well, it appears to be contact one leg to the other leg at the receiver was down at that spot. They're going to bring this ball back.
Is any kind of contact what defines contact?
Any contact between the two opponents.
You can tell my brother likes instant replay challenges just like me, Sean.
Well, he's enjoying it at the moment. The younger brother of our friend and colleague and partner, John Gruden. I mean, outwardly, John, I would say he is the more easygoing of the two. You know, we see a lot of shots of him like that. But does he share your intensity when it comes to these competitors?
That's a great observation. You know that we have nothing in common. I used to go to school, and they thought something was wrong with Jay. You're nothing like your older brother. Then my older brother, Jim's a doctor. He's a genius, and I'm a 2.0 guy. And then Jay comes along. The three of us Grudens have nothing in common.
The runner was touched down by contact at the 26-yard line. The ball will therefore be placed on the 26-yard line.
Jay looks good, 50 years old. He said when he hit 50, he realized he needed to lose some weight. He's lost about 33 pounds, changed his diet, and got a little more exercise.
He's made an impact on me, too. I've been running.
Good.
Look at my suits are getting a little baggy. Eating a lot of oatmeal for breakfast and watching my cholesterol. Thank you, brother. Second down and four as we resume play here in Philadelphia. At some point.
Under 6 minutes to go in the half. Wendell Smallwood. Poor tackling there. Looked like Matt Ioannidis, having a homecoming tonight, was going to stop him right near the line of scrimmage, but he didn't wrap him up. Ioannidis out of Temple really improved significantly in his second year, but that wasn't his best.
And they're trying to jumpstart the offense by using an up-tempo system that has really bothered Washington. They have not done well in the two-minute drill or against up-tempo offenses.
After the five-yard gain, more running room for Smallwood. And the fans appreciate that effort as he drives forward for a gain of nine.
Rev up the tempo. Feed. Wendell Smallwood running hard. Good movement off the right side, and it's second and one.
And the tempo quickens again. Mason Foster.
Wow, Preston.
Preston Smith, 94, not 54. He was there to rock Smallwood short of the first down.
Great spin move by Smith working against Jason Peters. Watch him spin to the inside and reject Smallwood. Watch him sneak.
Wentz using his size to pick up the first down. He's every bit of 6'5", 237 pounds.
But watch Wentz right here, Sean. This is a second-year quarterback that has got a lot of leeway at the line of scrimmage. They're going to let Wentz get to whatever he sees fit.
And they stick with the tempo. Wentz avoided Kerrigan, but now he's down. The ball came out for a moment. He got it back. Kerrigan there with Zach Brown for a sack as we tick down to 4 minutes to go in the half.
Wentz is disgusted with himself. This is a bootleg. This ball has got to be thrown. They're not even blocking Kerrigan. He knows a lot better than this. That's the one thing, talking to John DeFilippo, the quarterback coach, before the game. He said he is, at times, too aggressive, tries to make too much happen, and he takes too many hits.
He took a beating in that win at Carolina a week ago Thursday. Sacked three times, hit eight other times. He has really earned the respect of his teammates with that toughness. Going for a deep ball. Has a man behind the defense. It's caught for a touchdown. The rookie, Mack Hollins, with his first career touchdown, 64 yards.
That summarizes Carson Wentz. We talked about it in the open. He is not tough. He is North Dakota tough. The man just gets smashed, and he gets up the next play and throws a bomb for a touchdown. He did it against the Chargers. He did it against the Panthers, and he does it again in the Washington Redskins on a beautiful double move against DJ Swearinger. You earn a lot of respect with your football team when you can make a play like that after getting crushed.
Jake Elliott on to try to tie the game. For a moment, Hollins will never forget his first NFL touchdown. 64 yards from Carson Wentz. Hollins, a speedy receiver, walked on at North Carolina, left there as the all-time leader in yards per catch, more than 18 yards per reception during his time at Carolina. That's his specialty, going deep, and Wentz did not miss him.
Talked about this in the open. Just studying Wentz coming in here. He's North Dakota tough. He gets hit by three Washington Redskins. It doesn't bother him. He plays better after he gets hit. He stands in there with amnesia like nothing happened and throws a perfect pass. And if you look around this stadium tonight,
it's not a coincidence that there are a lot of number 11 jerseys. I got off the airplane. They used to make fun of me, Sean. They used to yell at me when I walked in the airport. There's Wentz jerseys everywhere. This guy has totally taken this town by storm.
Well, you are not the most popular guy in Philadelphia, even though you coached here. You brought your Tampa Bay team in here, won the NFC Championship game in the last Eagle game at Old Veterans Stadium. Then you christened this stadium the first game the next year, and you beat the Eagles again.
So I got some prank phone calls last night at the Rittenhouse. These Eagle fans, they love their football, but this young man has taken this town by storm. And I think he fits this city of Philadelphia perfectly. Blue collar, tough. They appreciate guys that go to the wall. What's that movie, Rocky Balboa?
Mm-hmm. Well, you
a little bit of Rocky and Wentz.
You saw in Carson Wentz the same thing the Eagles saw. We're going into that draft, a lot of debate about who would be the better player. Would it be Jared Goff or Carson Wentz? And when the Eagles did their preparation, they really wanted Carson Wentz. Wasn't a negative from Jared Goff. They just loved everything about Carson Wentz. They traded up a couple of times to get the second pick in the draft and wound up with Wentz. Now in a tie game, Cousins swung it out to Chris Thompson, who goes across the boundary about 3 yards short of the first down.
You know, Sean, I love the line coach of the Redskins, Bill Callahan, and you see Morgan Moses out there playing at right tackle. That's one tough player. He's been hurt twice. There's Bill Callahan. He's put together this Hogs group, much like he did with the Dallas Cowboys. They've got two top five picks, and he's got them both playing great. Williams at left tackle, Sheriff at right guard, and they epitomize his toughness.
Chris Thompson, the running back again, running right. Chopped down short of the first down by Jalen Mills. But you talk about Bill Callahan. We visited with Brandon Sheriff last night, talking about when he came out of Iowa. He won the Outland Trophy. He was a top five pick in the draft. He was a left tackle. And Bill Callahan said immediately, we're going to move you to right guard. That could be a big kick to somebody's ego. But he said, I remember that Bill Callahan took Zach Martin in Dallas, a left tackle, made him a right guard. He's one of the best guards in football. I trusted in him. I believed in him. And he's become a great right guard.
Certainly has. Third and one.
Washington is 0 for 4 on third down. Cousins surveys the field. Really nobody open. Crowder just a fraction ahead of Patrick Robinson. That gets us to the 2-minute warning. Moss breaking down the performances of Kirk Cousins and Carson Wentz. Scott Van Pelt will have an interview with James Franklin, head coach Penn State, now 7-0 after their big win in state college Saturday night against Michigan. They're ranked number 2 in the country behind Alabama. Lots of smiles on the faces of football fans here in Pennsylvania. Tough schedule still ahead, though, for James Franklin and those Nittany Lions. Tressway's punt. Fair catch made on the juggle by Kenyon Barner. 46-yard punt. The route to the NFL for Carson Wentz began at Bismarck Century High School in North Dakota. He was the Class 3A State Player of the Year, not heavily recruited. Elected to go to North Dakota State. Waited 3 years to become the starter. 2 years as the starter, won 2 national titles. Selected 2nd overall last year after the Eagles twice traded up. And it's still staggering to believe that the Cleveland Browns, who have been in search of a quarterback forever, continue to pass on guys like Carson Wentz.
That's for another show.
Yes, it is. Plenty of time for the Eagles. They start from their own 20, a minute 52 to go and a half. Wentz takes off running and gets shoved as he was crossing the sideline. No flag down as he took a shove in the back from Zach Brown. It is a first down. There's a flag down, but it's all the way on the other side of the field.
And it's against Washington.
Well, the quarterback still had the ball, holding defense number 26. 5-yard penalty. Wow. Tacked on First down.
How you call some of these penalties when you're the left corner and the ball's being run on the opposite side of the field? Breland can't believe it.
That flag was outside the numbers on the opposite side of the field, almost on the other sideline.
Let these guys play a little bit. First down, Philadelphia. They've had a lot of success in the no huddle tonight, and Washington has really struggled in the two-minute drill at the end of both halves.
And even the most easygoing of the Gruden brothers starting to get a little fired up on that sideline. Here's Wentz deep down the field and caught. Still on his feet, Zach Ertz, and he's tripped up by Kendall Fuller. That saved the touchdown, but it's a huge gainer to the 18-yard line, 46 yards.
Well, it's all the blitz pickup by Wendell Smallwood, and Foster, who was injured coming in here tonight, no match for Ertz, who has really come into his own as a great receiver.
46-yard play, his first catch tonight. Smallwood ducked down to the 14-yard line. 1 minute to go in the first half. Philadelphia trying to take the lead.
Plenty of time, but I love watching Carson Wentz running the show. I know it was North Dakota State, but this is how he took control of games as a collegiate.
Another penalty. Direct Aguilar toward the end zone. There is a flag down near the line of scrimmage.
No idea what this is.
Ineligible downfield by the offense, number 62. 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Center Jason Kelce. It has been a struggle for the Redskins in the final 2 minutes of the halves. This season they've allowed a league high 44 points combined, 17 the final 2 minutes of the second quarter, 27 at the end of the fourth quarter, tied with Cincinnati for the most allowed.
A lot of injuries in the secondary and new signal callers on defense. Big reason why.
Ball back at the 19, well within field goal range at the very least for Elliott. Short throw to Smallwood, trying to leap over the tackler and could not get away from Quentin Dunbar. And a timeout called by the Eagles with third down and three upcoming. We talked earlier, one of the many reasons why the Eagles have been so successful this year, the play of their quarterback on third down. He leads the league with 7 third down touchdown passes. 55% of his throws on third down have resulted in a first down. And his passer rating on third down is best in the league. Tom Brady second in the percentage and rating numbers.
Well, it's his scrambling ability. You know, you look at those numbers, you have to ask yourself, how is that possible? He's got so much more command, and he's fixed over 50 plays with audibles and scrambles. Look for that here.
Last year's passer rating was 28th in the league on third down, better than only Blake Bortles and Ryan Fitzpatrick. He lobs one for Jeffrey. A lot of hand fighting with Dunbar, and here comes the flag.
Well, I don't see this at all. This is this is pro football.
Pass interference, defense number 47. The foul occurred in the end zone. The ball will be placed at the 1 yard line. First down.
And here comes LeGarrette Blount.
12th accepted penalty in the game. This is the specialty for LeGarrette Blount. 11 one-yard touchdown runs last season tied the NFL record. Washington, knowing he was going to get the ball, stacks him up for a loss back near the four, led by Mason Foster. And the Eagles use their second timeout.
You see Doug Peterson talking to Carson Wentz on the sideline. They have the most creative plus-five offense in football, arguably, Andy Reid of Kansas City, Doug Peterson, who worked together for a long time. They have some plays. You see them laughing. Shifts, empty formations. There's a lot of strange plays that Doug Peterson calls upon inside the five-yard line. This will be interesting. Redskins got to be alert to take a timeout on defense if they see anything bizarre.
When they get inside the five-yard line this season, they score touchdowns. They had it at the one, loss of three on first down. 26 seconds to go, a timeout for the Eagles. And now a Washington timeout.
That's a good timeout. Jay Gruden knows when you play Doug Peterson and Andy Reid, anything goes. And they ran a crazy shift in week one. They scored a touchdown. And right now, he's going to make sure his defense has time to get ready. Zach Ertz has been the go-to man. He has four touchdown receptions, and believe it or not, Philadelphia has put in plays. I have seen them run at North Dakota State. Wentz has got them in this offense.
And they've used them effectively. He's had a lot more input into the offense this year as he's learned more, and the coaches have more faith in his ability. Make adjustments to the line of scrimmage. In the flat, nice move, and Zach Ertz gives Philadelphia its first lead of the night.
That's a great receiver, and he's had great success against the Redskins. Five touchdown catches for Ertz. Just a flat route. He beats Swearinger after the catch with open field running. Wentz caught 36 as a rookie, caught 58. Then he caught 75 and 78. And I bet you he comes close to 90 this year.
Washington's woes at the end of the half continue. Jake Elliott adds the extra point. 22 seconds to go in the half. They went 80 yards in just a minute and a half. What a connection being formed by Wentz and Ertz. John mentioned five touchdowns this year for Ertz, and all five of them have been when they've been in the end zone, or in the red zone, rather.
Really coming into his own. I think sometimes Carson Wentz could complete passes to Zach Ertz with his eyes closed. Just such a natural route runner. He did it at Stanford. I remember talking to David Shaw, the head coach at Stanford. I said, who is Zach Ertz? He said, oh, you'll like him. He is the best receiver we have coached here, and he and Carson Wentz have something going. His wife's a great athlete.
Yeah, Julie is one of the best women soccer players on the U.S. national team. Niles Paul.
Holy cow.
There's Julie. This is from this weekend, playing for the national team. Thursday against South Korea, she had that spectacular diving header. Sunday, in Cary, North Carolina, she scored in the 45th minute to wrap up that two-match friendly series with a victory. She has five goals and six appearances for the national team this year. Hard to know who's been the better athlete in that couple.
It's quite a couple.
Former Julie Johnston. And Kirk Cousins, 12 out of 16 for 167. And a touchdown, a terrific first half, but his team on the short end of the score, 17-10, Philadelphia, and the Eagles will get the ball to start the second half. We'll join Susie Culber and the crew for the Toyota halftime in 30 seconds. Active to the Eagles Hall of Fame. 17-10, the Eagles have the lead at the half. Quarterback comparison, 15 yards more for Kirk Cousins than Carson Wentz, but Wentz picked it up late in the half. As a matter of fact, he hit on his last five passes. Time for tonight's third quarter reset presented by Cognizant. And we talk about the reset. Looked like the coaches helped reset the night for Carson Wentz when they went up-tempo at the end of the half.
They go up-tempo, and then Washington made him mad. They sacked him, and Carson Wentz got North Dakota tough again. But he hung in there. He threw this bomb to Hollins after getting sacked, which really ignited this place. And then he took him down the field in a two-minute drill in the up-tempo offense again. You can't throw the ball much better than that. Then he found Ertz again for a touchdown pass to give Philly a 17-10 lead. Up-tempo offense, something Philly's good at, something Washington struggles against. I'd be surprised if Doug Peterson and Wentz don't stay on the gas pedal.
Ryan Kerrigan and the Redskins defense did a good job getting after Wentz early in the half. They talked about trying to pressure him up the middle. That worked for a while early in the game. There's Nick Rose, the rookie kicker out of Highland Park High School in Dallas, Texas, the alma mater of Matthew Stafford and Clayton Kershaw. Graduated from the University of Texas 2.5 years ago, made his NFL debut tonight. He's waited a long time for this opportunity. He's made his only field goal try and kicked his only extra point. Kenyon Barner's going to try this one from the middle of the end zone. And a bad decision. He made it just to the 19-yard line. Stephen McClure made the tackle. There's Pennsylvania Sports Hall of Famer Lisa Salters. Hello, Lisa.
Hey, Sean. Well, for most of the first half, the Eagles offense seemed to struggle. So I asked Doug Peterson what changed with those last two drives to end the half. And he said it was something he talked to his guys about during the week, warned them about coming out sluggish after having so much time off. The Eagles last played on a Thursday night 10 days ago. Peterson said he tried to warn them about making mistakes, which is what they did early. But he said he was pleased with the way they rebounded, got their sea legs under them, and finished the half strong with big plays and two touchdowns. Sean.
All right, Lisa, thank you. On first down, LeGarrette Blount. 2-yard gain. We want to congratulate Lisa. About a week and a half ago, inducted into the Montgomery County chapter of the Pennsylvania Sports wow. Hall of Fame. Lisa, native of the Philadelphia area from King of Prussia, about 20 miles northwest of here. Great athlete in high school, over 1,000 points at Upper Marion, walked on at Penn State.
This lady's going to be tough to deal with now.
We're really proud of you, Lisa. I know it's
way
a
to go,
night
Salters.
For you and
thank
your family.
You guys. It was quite an honor, very unexpected, but quite an honor. When you start a career, you never expect something like that. So I'm very humbled by all of it.
Well, well deserved. She was recommended by Blair Thomas, former outstanding Penn State football player. Really proud of Lisa. Nelson Aguilar, the catch and a first down. Across the 30 to the 35-yard line, 14 yards.
I like this Aguilar. And uh-oh, Jason Peters, Pro Bowl left tackle, is down. Holding his right knee.
Still going strong at age 35. Reason for concern for Coach Peterson. Timeout.
PM.
Are you ready?
We're back live in Philadelphia, and unfortunately, Jason Peters still on the field with what seems to be a serious leg injury. Immobilizing that leg. One of the great players of his era, 9-time Pro Bowler. Let's go back and look at the play on which he got hurt.
Let's see his right knee.
Boy.
Ziggy Hood got rolled into Peters' right knee, and Peters, 9 times he's been to the Pro Bowl.
And that's as an undrafted player out of the University of Arkansas way back in 2004. He was a tight end. Signed for a $5,000 signing bonus and wound up as a tackle. More Pro Bowl appearances by any undrafted offensive lineman since the merger back in 1970. Much loved on this team. Many of his teammates running out there.
This is a huge loss for the Eagles and for football. This man, 35 years old, not many better guys than Jason Peters, have worked to get to where he is from where he came from. And you can see the love that he has from his teammates, even the respect of the Redskins.
And the sacrifices that players make to help the team win. He took a pay cut. in this offseason to allow them to go out and sign other players like Alshon Jeffrey and Torrey Smith and Chris Long. They extended his contract as sort of a trade-off. Saw Trent Williams come over. He's playing on an injured left knee. We saw the great Joe Thomas go down for the first time in his career for more than 10,000 snaps without missing a play. Tricep injury. Crowd chanting the name of Jason Peters.
And what will Philadelphia do? Will they move right tackle Lane Johnson, who was the fourth overall pick, to left tackle? I think they're going to leave Johnson alone at right tackle, but in the long term, he'll be the answer. I believe it'll be 72 Vitae.
Kalapuli Vaitai started at right tackle last week when Johnson was out with a concussion. Over the middle, juggling catch made by Nelson Aguilar, and he has the first down to the 45-yard line.
What a comeback Aguilar has made. Former first-round pick, they benched him last year at midseason. Lost his confidence. Had a hard time lining up, hard time catching the football, and has really found a home in the slot in this Eagles offense. Reliable young receiver, good to see him realizing his talents.
We were here last year for Monday Night Football game. They sat him out just as a mental break as much as anything else. He was really struggling with his play and his confidence. Trey Burton, one of their tight ends, shoved out of bounds in Redskin territory at the 48. It's a whole new year for Aguilar in his third year. It looked like last year he was about to be pronounced forever as a bust. First round pick, number 20 overall out of USC. November last year, really hit rock bottom. He was penalized for lining up illegally on an Eagles touchdown play of over 50 yards. Brought back the touchdown they lost in Seattle. And after the game, he admitted he had lost his confidence completely. Deep throw. Looking for Marcus Johnson.
It's Quentin Dunbar. He has no conscience. As a pass interference call at the end of the first half, he could care less. He comes back down after down, and he has seen a lot of action in replacing Josh Norman. Just the go route, the former Texas Longhorn Johnson, well covered by Dunbar. And Ryan Kerrigan has gone over to meet Vitae on a critical third down.
They have left Lane Johnson at right tackle, put Vitae in at left tackle for Peters. Wentz, the zone read, fake to Blunt, much more than the first down. He rumbles down to the 27-yard line.
When you least expect it. There's so many things this man can do. Running, passing, audibling. Not even going to block. The end man on the line of scrimmage. Wentz reads him, and off he goes. 6'5", 240 pounds, has improved in every area. Here comes Philadelphia.
21-yard gain for Wentz. His third rushing first down of the night, his 13th of the season. A blitz from Washington. Wentz, a bullet over the middle, caught inside the 10-yard line by Zach Ertz.
When you blitz, you play man-to-man coverage, and you know exactly where Carson Wentz is going. Right side of your screen, Zach Ertz on a little post pattern. Beats Swearinger. For the third time, Swearinger has been beaten in coverage.
So many options for the Eagles. With Wentz as the dual threat at quarterback, they love Ertz, as we've already seen in the red zone. This guy's not bad close to the goal line either. LeGarrette Blunt to the 4-yard line.
Here comes the receivers. Hollins, Aguilar, Torrey Smith. They will spread you out and use a check with me with Carson Wentz. Watch him carefully at the line of scrimmage. Expect the shift.
A lot of shifts.
They've blown the coverage.
Now Washington scrambling to get lined up. And it looked like Vitae, the replacement for Peters at left tackle, was backpedaling early.
Well, we told you Peterson had a lot of crazy plays.
Number 72, 5-yard penalty, the second down.
When you practice shifts and practice crazy plays, they better look good on the practice field two or three times. But sometimes your backup left tackle doesn't get the reps. And that's clearly what happened there to Vitae. Second down and 9. Ertz, 86. Going to be split in the slot, and they love him in the tight red zone.
Kill, 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 yeah, yeah.
Playing way off Ertz. Wentz back to the end zone, incomplete. A little too high for Alshon Jeffrey with Kendall Fuller, second year defender out of Virginia Tech, in coverage.
Well, you heard Carson Wentz kill the play. Probably had a man-to-man beater called. He killed it to defeat the zone, and he had a wide-open receiver. He just missed the throw.
Doug Peterson calling the play. Third down and goal. Big play here. Washington trying to force the field goal try. The Eagles trying to take the largest lead of the night for either team. They can go up by 2 scores. They'd like the touchdown from the 9-yard line. Wentz stays on his feet, gets it off, and it's a touchdown. Corey Clement, the rookie out of Wisconsin.
Carson Wentz is unbelievable. That's the same play that they featured at North Dakota State. He went to Doug Peterson. He said, I want to put this play in our offense. They threw it for a touchdown against the Giants, and now they throw it for a touchdown against the Redskins. And how about that pocket toughness? How does he get away from all these free rushers and make throws like that?
Big and strong, great pocket presence. A lot of quarterbacks who would not have survived that pressure to complete the play and throw the touchdown pass. 9 yards. Ten plays and 81 yards. Took up more than 5 minutes. Touchdowns in each of the last 3 possessions for Philadelphia. The rookie Jake Elliott out of Memphis broke most of Steven Gostkowski's kicking records. Adds the extra point.
Want to be a big-time quarterback. Two hands on the ball. Push forward. Give your receivers a chance and exhibit
tough passes tonight. This is game 7 of the season. He's thrown 16 touchdown passes. He has tied the Eagles franchise record for most TD passes in the first 7 games of the season. And how about the two men he shares that mark with? Chance to break it tonight. Legends Norm Van Brocklin and Donovan McNabb.
Some company right there. He deserves it. I can't tell you how impressed I am with him. Wow.
And he's starting to exert his influence on the coaching staff. You've talked about it a couple times tonight. He got them to put a play right out of the North Dakota State playbook.
Sure did. This is 2 tight ends at the bottom of the screen. They like to throw this wide departure post to Zach Ertz. But look at the back in the flat. They put him in the flat as well. Now it's the same play. And he doesn't throw it to Ertz, but he throws it to the back in the flat. This is a play that they ran at North Dakota State 15 times inside the 5-yard line. He has asserted himself. He has come in here and told these coaches what he likes, what he doesn't like, and they trust him, and that's going to go a long way in his greatness.
And the Redskins had seen that on film because they ran it against the Giants earlier this year, too. Cousins got decked as he got it off, an incomplete pass, and you get the sense that the game is starting to slip away from the Redskins here, but a lot of time left with 9:39 to go in the third quarter.
Well, when you're Philadelphia's offense and you hold the ball for almost 6 minutes, your defensive line is fresh. There's a song called Fresh I listen to when I think of the Eagles' defensive line. These guys are always fresh, always rotating, and always in your face.
Second and 10. Big possession for the Redskins. On target. Cousins to Reed. He's swung around and down by Rodney McLeod. We talk about the song Fresh Philadelphia, of course, the original home of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, played by Philadelphia native Will Smith. You were singing that song all week. You want to sing it in the background? We talk about it. No, I didn't think so.
Seven defensive linemen, though, have played 150 or more snaps. These men are like relief pitchers. They come in out of the bullpen fresh as daisies for these critical third downs in the noise, and they're effective.
And they're not just bodies, they're talented bodies. Six of the seven first or second round draft picks. They get close to Cousins. He threw a wobbler, but it got to Reed for a big first down for the Redskins. Malcolm Jenkins made the tackle.
And this is a big gut check for the Skins. Once again, Jordan Reed comes out of the game with an injury. He's had chest problems, rib problems, and Cousins makes a great throw from an awkward delivery for a big first down. And there's Jordan Reed, a man that just has not been healthy for a day this season.
Second catch of the night, good for 6 yards and the first down. There's Thompson, only about 185 pounds, a tough run. He admits he's just 5'7", but he is tough, and that's to the 41-yard line.
And you see Chris Long just check in, Sean. He's one of those fresh campers. Played in New England last year. He was an outside linebacker. I saw him dropping in coverage a lot. I didn't think the scheme fit him. He said, you know what, I'm going to come to Philadelphia, put my hand in the grass, and come off the rock. This was a perfect scheme fit for him.
After 8 years in St. Louis, he chose to go to New England because he wanted to win, and that worked out well. They won the Super Bowl in his only year there. Vernon Davis wrestled down by Corey Graham. And give Chris Long credit as a prognosticator, because he told us in our visit on Saturday the reason he came here to Philadelphia is he saw this coming. He really believed they were a team on the rise.
And he knows football. This man comes from a football family, and he knew they had a great young quarterback and some talented defensive linemen to play with. 96, Barnett at the bottom of the screen working with Graham, who has gone inside. The great Fletcher Cox and Chris Long, a formidable outfit.
I mentioned the rotating defensive front. Both Barnett and Long are backups. They're fresh as they come after Cousins, and his throw is too high. For Jamison Crowder, Patrick Robinson had the coverage.
See, all-out blitz again. And if you don't have time to change the play, sometimes you got to take a timeout and reload. But Philadelphia is going to outnumber the Redskins. It's an all-out blitz. And Patrick Robinson has taken Jamison Crowder away.
Tress way to punt. You talked about on the pregame, they don't blitz a lot, but when they do, they tend to bring everybody. And it is very effective for Jim Schwartz. Kenyon Barner, the fair catch. 41-yard punt. Gorgeous night here in Philadelphia. First of three straight home games for the Eagles, trying to go to 6-1. Take firm control of the NFC East. They've already played four away games. One of the impressive factors of that, aspects of that 5-1 start, four of the six games have been on the road. Their remaining schedule is third easiest in the league based on the combined winning percentage to date this season of their remaining opponents. Only Jacksonville and Pittsburgh have easier schedules. So they can have a big cushion in that NFC East after tonight. LeGarrette Blount taken down by Matt Ioannidis.
Time of possession is where Philadelphia has dominated. They lead the NFL in time of possession. They convert more third downs than anyone. They've got a balanced offense. But look at Chip Kelly the last 3 years. They're last in time of possession. Now they're at 34 minutes a game.
And LeGarrette Blount had that going in the wrong direction for more possession time than he would have liked. Zach Brown took him down way back inside the 12-yard line.
And Philadelphia playing with a backup left tackle. Let's remind everyone, Jason Peters, their great offensive tackle, carried away with a knee injury. Vitae has come in, a backup left tackle.
It'll be Junior Gallette squaring off against him, but I'd be very aware of a screen here if I were the Redskins.
You mentioned a couple of times Philadelphia, the best third down team in the league, the best at third and 10 plus. This is third and 16. They're trying to set up a screen, and they do. Brent Celek taken down after a short gain. So the Eagles, who had scored touchdowns on their previous three possessions, all of them drives of 80 yards or more that ended in a touchdown pass from Wentz, they go three and out this time.
Redskins have got nothing from their return game this year, Sean, and in this backed up situation, will Jamison Crowder get it together as a returner? He had a couple dynamic returns a year ago. Dangerous man, the ex-Duke Blue Devil.
Donnie Jones the punt, room on the catch for Crowder. An excellent field position for Washington. Crowder didn't think he was down, but they are going to mark him down at the Washington 48-yard line. 4:48 to go, third quarter. Monday Night Football. Rothman, our director, Chip Dean, our outstanding Monday Night Football crew. Delighted to have you with us from Lincoln Financial Field. The Philadelphia Eagles, best record in the league, 5-1, trying to go to 6-1. Lead by 14 with under 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Excellent field position on this start to the drive for Kirk Cousins in Washington from their own 48. Good catch made by Vernon Davis with the defender Najee Good right there on him.
And his defensive line, I'm going to continue to say it as we head home.
They are fresh
and ready to go. Look at the snaps that they have distributed tonight. Cox has only played 30. That song, they're fresh.
Fresh.
They look fresh.
Cool in the Gang.
I love Cool in the Gang.
Big hit back in 1984. Peaked at number 11 on the charts. And I'm told that reading about it on Wikipedia, where of course all reliable information comes from, Barnett, one of those fresh defensive linemen, I'm told that a fresh means good. It kind of gave a new meaning to the word fresh. And then they're both fresh in terms of their rested, and they're also very good. So they're fresh by any connotation.
No doubt about that. And the Redskins' tackles are hurting. Williams has not been himself at left tackle, hasn't practiced in 2 weeks. He's got a bad knee. The right tackle, Morgan Moses, has come out of this game twice with both ankles hurt. And now their center's out of the game.
Spencer Long just limped off. Chase Roullier in at center. Rookie out of Wyoming. Sixth round pick.
Is it an all-out blitz?
Yeah. Why wouldn't you with the new center in there? Looked like Cox might have moved early. There is not a flag down. Cousins with some running room. Gets belted on that right arm, but he's very close to the first down. He got rocked by Malcolm Jenkins.
That's a great effort by Cousins. That's the ninth time he's run for first downs this year. This is uncommon for him. And he's selling out for his football team. Nice work.
They had a mic, as they often do, last week. They picked up a conversation that Cousins had with Trent Williams on the sideline. Williams talking about when he got hit in the right arm last week. Told him that's about a $200 million shoulder that you might need to think more about protecting. Wow. Wide open receiver Josh Doctson inside the 25-yard line in Washington after a prolonged dry spell on the move here.
That's a great throw between the corner and the safety under pressure. Cousins down two scores. Puts the ball in the hole between the corner and Malcolm Jenkins. First down, Washington. Terrell Pryor has just checked in at the top of the screen. First time we've seen him tonight.
Big target number 11. Caught 77 passes for Cleveland last year. Has not done much so far as a Redskin. Thompson with great balance. He went spinning through the Eagles and picked up 7.
Thompson's been the man for Washington. He's come out of more trash than most backs I've seen this year. And he almost makes another miraculous run. Second down and 3. Jordan Reed has checked back into the game at his regular tight end position.
Going Long, and Moses, who's gone out a couple of times, is in it right tackle. Cousins got away from Cox, needs to get rid of it. Waited much too long. Malcolm Jenkins, the sack, back at the 25-yard line.
Great play by Jenkins, and Josh Dotson, Jamison Crowder, come back to your quarterback. Someone separate. You're going to see Jenkins 27. Excuse me, he's right here at a linebacker position with the sack, but coverage down the field held up, but these young receivers have to come back to their quarterback, and Cousins got to throw it away.
Second sack of the night for the Eagles. Third down and 11. Cousins steps into the throw, and it's right on target for a big first down to Jordan Reed. It'll be first and goal from the 5-yard line.
Now it's Brandon Scherer.
Oh, wow.
We've seen almost every Washington Redskin offensive lineman go down tonight.
And give them credit. I mean, we mentioned Trent Williams hasn't practiced in a couple of weeks on a very sore knee, right knee. Jay Gruden said he probably won't practice again the rest of the year. And there's Sheriff getting rolled up on. Top five pick in the draft in 2015. He was number 5 overall. Trent Williams was the number 4 pick in the 2010 draft. There are only 8 offensive linemen in the league who were taken in the top 5 picks of their draft, and Washington has 2 of them. They're the only team with 2 of them, and Williams and Sheriff. He is in excruciating pain.
Brandon Graham was blocked low into that left knee. I've already seen Jason Peters, one of the best in all of football. Left tackle of the Eagles carried away, and this is one of the top offensive linemen in football on the Redskins.
And another terrific guy. We had a chance to visit with him last night. As a sophomore in high school, he was a quarterback, 295 pounds. And played quarterback, wanted to continue playing quarterback. Kirk Ferentz and the Iowa staff, because he had great feet and was 295 pounds, they offered him a scholarship, but they told him, you can keep playing quarterback in high school. When you get here, you're going to be an offensive lineman. So he played offensive line his last 2 years in high school and became one of the great linemen in all of college football for Coach Ferentz. That staff at Iowa has done a great job producing offensive linemen.
So he's all right. What a throw by Cousins to Reed. First and goal.
Spencer Long back in at center. Rod Kelly, the running back for the Redskins. On first and goal from inside the 5, the quick slant to Jordan Reed for a Washington touchdown.
That's impressive. Kirk Cousins hung in there, made some great deliveries, and Jordan Reed on a one-step bullet slant makes this real interesting. One-step bullet slant. Cousins almost crouched like he dropped the snap. He crouches, gets up, and throws a dart.
What was the point of the crouch, do you think?
Well, he's probably trying to hide from the edge rusher so they don't bat that ball down, Sean. And Matt Cavanaugh, the quarterback coach, Kirk Cousins, they have a lot of fundamental work, technique work for throws like that, and it paid off.
There's Nick Rose in his NFL debut tonight. Trouble with the hold, and Rose just did get it through. Blake Tressway was struggling to get the snap from Nick Sundberg down. They add the extra point, and it's a 7-point game.
It's Kevin O'Connell, the quarterback coach, I should say, but even the kicker is hurt for the Redskins. We have seen a lot of Washington Redskins in the last few weeks on Monday Night Football, and unfortunately, we have seen a lot of them get injured. But Jordan Reed, 2 great plays. Long yardage pass, he gets a seam pattern, and Cousins does an excellent job getting the ball up over the underneath coverage and down quickly before the safety can arrive. That's toughness in a crowd. And then the bullet slant. J-
Jordan Reed's first touchdown of the season, Sean. And much like Philadelphia has Zach Ertz, Washington has Jordan Reed.
He hasn't had 50 yards receiving in a game this year as he's battled the injuries. Last year he played in 12 games. He has 50 yards or more receiving in 8 of the 12. So he's capable of giving them more, and they're hoping he'll get healthy and give them more. Kickoff is a touchback.
Well, can Philadelphia stay with this no-huddle offense that was successful for them early with a backup at left tackle? Things are a little bit different when you don't have Jason Peters, let me tell you.
After a slow start, some of those pressures up the middle from Washington effective early in the game, Wentz settled in. He's thrown only 20 passes tonight. He averages 38 attempts per game. He's the only quarterback who started every game for his team this year who's thrown at least 30 passes in every game. He may not get to that number tonight with the lead as we're heading to the fourth quarter. LeGarrette Blount, the ball carrier, short gain as he was taken down by Kendall Fuller. And we're in the final half minute of the third quarter.
Here comes that no-huddle offense. He's going to take the quarter.
They don't have to snap it. The play clock is at 10. End of three. Asking the question, which is the best team in the NFC after tonight's action between the Eagles and the Redskins? James Franklin, the Penn State coach, will talk about his tremendous running back, Saquon Barkley. That and more coming up in SportsCenter at night with SVP. Second and 8, Eagles leading by a touchdown as we go to the fourth quarter. Wentz in traffic through to an unsuspecting Alshon Jeffrey.
Washington applies the blitz, and Wentz forced to unload it. Third down and 9. Wendell Smallwood has checked back into the game. He's made some great hidden plays tonight, picking up blitzes.
See if Greg Minuski brings the pressure again. Went 7 out of 10 against the blitz. Lined up as if they're coming after him, and they do. And he's in trouble. Wentz will be escaping from the 18-yard line. How in the world did that happen? First down out to the 44-yard line.
He's just breaking the hearts of the Washington Redskins. Wendell Smallwood gets run over. Was he down? Where did he go? Amazing. He came out of a pile of bodies. And he's not down.
Nope. Looked like it was going to be a loss of 9. It turned into a gain of 17. And a first down. And the critical play of the game to this point for sure. Nearly a minute gone by in the fourth quarter. They came after him again. Ertz tackled along the far sideline.
I coach Randall Cunningham, and I remember Frank Gifford saying, how about that agility? They've always had scrambling quarterbacks. Then I had to deal with Donovan McNabb, and he broke people's hearts for a long time around here. Getting out of trouble, scrambling. He was awesome. Cunningham, McNabb, and now they have Wentz. He's as good as these two guys.
Smallwood stuffed by Zach Brown. And really started in that opener against the Redskins this year. He had an unbelievable scramble to throw a long touchdown pass to Nelson Agholor in the first touchdown of the year. But this looked for sure like it was going to be a sack.
He's done an unbelievable job scrambling, passing, competing, improving. And it's North Dakota tough.
And they convert on another third down. A handoff. Corey Clement, and he is out of bounds. It'll depend on the mark.
Well, he got a good spot.
Boy, he sure did.
I thought he was out of bounds.
The sideline, the Eagles sideline. They're going to line up quickly, and I would not be surprised if Jay Gruden challenges this.
He's going to have to get some information from his coaches upstairs in a hurry.
It doesn't appear they're going to stop it. Wentz after the short fake, it's caught. Alshon Jeffrey with Dunbar right there. And a little whooping between the two of them after the play.
A lot of great acquisitions. And Jeffrey is one of them. The one thing he can do is he can catch the fly and the fly stop. And Wentz laid it in there perfectly.
Excruciating possession here for the Redskin fans. Several times it looked like they were in position to make a big play, and it's Philadelphia who keeps making them. 12 minutes to go. They're in field goal range, which would make it a two-score game. Ertz, another first down to the 10-yard line, taken down by DJ Swearinger.
Wentz is running the show. Play action pass. It's a run pass with a built-in pass option, and they give him the freedom to hand it or deal it.
5 catches for Ertz tonight.
Easy, easy. Hey, purple 65. Red deer. Red deer. Red deer.
Inside fake and another touchdown. Fourth of the night thrown by Wentz. This one to Nelson Agholor.
One of the things you always look for in quarterbacks is recognition, communication, execution. He read the defense all the way. You heard him audible to purple 65. He communicates it. Everybody has it. And then he executes it to sheer perfection. Play action pass. He fools the underneath coverage. And what a performance he's put on tonight.
Well, that escape from the certain sack and run for the first down. One of the plays of the year in the NFL. Extra point good by Elliott. Back to Carson Wentz. Highlighted by his 17-yard run on third down at 8. That just ripped the momentum in this game away from the Redskins. Might be one of the most important plays of the year in this division when all is said and done. 4 touchdown passes for Carson Wentz tonight to 4 different receivers. He's rushed for a career high 64 yards. He's already rushed for more yards this season than he did all of last year. Agholor, the most recent recipient of a touchdown toss from Wentz. 4 touchdown passes ties the career high for Carson. Jake Elliott's kickoff down by Niles Paul.
Well, he's in complete control, Sean. He recognizes the 3-deep zone. He tells Corey Clement, hey, switch sides. I'm going to fake the ball to you and eliminate the underneath coverage. And we're going to run the triple seam. Ertz is going to hold the safety, and we're going to get Agholor right down the numbers. But he recognized it. He communicated. He executes the fake. And that's how the triple seam looks. Wentz. Amazing showtime tonight.
On first down, a screen against a sturdy rush. Good call by Jake Gruden. And they get 6 yards. Brandon Graham made the tackle. And now it's Patrick Robinson, the injured Philadelphia Eagle defensive back.
Boy, you talked about that body bag game earlier. There has been, unfortunately, too many men get hurt tonight, Sean. Sheriff, Peters, Hicks. We've seen Morgan Moses leave twice, and now Robinson. Robinson has come in here and played a lot of good football as the nickel corner, as the right corner, former number one pick of the Saints.
Let's head down to the field. Here's Lisa Salters.
Yeah, Sean. Well, Brandon Sheriff was in the medical evaluation tent twice. After he was in there the first time, he came out, tested that left knee, didn't like how it felt, went back into the tent. He's now back on the sideline. It appears that he's still trying to test it out, but he is also still listed as questionable to return.
It's good to see him walking around. It looked like a very severe injury when he went down. Perhaps it still is, but walking without much sign of a limp. They have Spencer Long back in the game at center. Chase Roullier, who played briefly at center when Long went out, is now playing right guard. They're running out of bodies on the offensive line. They were without their leading backup at tackle, Ty Nsicki, who has been inactive since week three with a core muscle injury. Moses gutting it out at right tackle. He's done gone down a couple of times. Second down and four. Cousins on target, but it's incomplete.
Once again, Terrell Pryor just can't find his game here as a Redskin.
Well, that's the play they have to have. If they're going to make the playoffs this year, this receiving core certainly needs to be more productive.
And that's stating it mildly.
Yes. Pryor's still learning a new position, a new offense. Give Cousins credit. He comes right back to him. He hangs on this time. Pryor was a quarterback in college at Ohio State, started his NFL career as a quarterback, started nine games for Oakland as a quarterback, wound up transitioning receiver when he wasn't good enough to play quarterback anymore.
Well, he's got to catch a ball in his hands. You got to reach for the ball, cut the flight time down. Everything's getting in on Terrell Pryor right now.
His first catch of the night, good for 6 yards. Cousins did well to hang on to that football as he got belted as he was winding up to throw. Fletcher Cox reintroduces himself to the Washington quarterback.
And Destiny Vial, number 97. There's Cox, 91. Not Vial, 97, converging on Cousins. It's what they do best, and it's what this scheme asks them to do the most.
9.5 minutes to go. 3 sacks for Philadelphia tonight. Thompson, another way to try to neutralize that rush with the quick throw. Thompson out to the 39-yard line. Corey Graham made the stop. They need to get just across the 45, a little more than 6 yards to go for a critical first down.
And Trent Williams, their Pro Bowl left tackle, playing on one leg, led that screen, pulling on the perimeter. Third down and 6. Backup beat up offensive lineman against the bullies from Broad Street. Let's see what happens.
Cousins deep drop, running out of time, and he got hit as he threw it. It's picked off. Corey Graham shoved out of bounds by Chris Thompson. Looked like they got enough of Cousins to alter that throw right into the lap of the 10-year veteran out of the University of New Hampshire, Graham.
Pass rush. It's all the pass rush. Graham, 55. Gets a piece of Kirk Cousins' arm. He causes the interception, and just like Fletcher Cox did it to Cam Newton last week, Graham forces an interception this week. The bullies on Broad Street. I remember coaching here. They talked about Reggie White and Jerome Brown and Mike Pitts and Clyde Simmons and that guy Golick. They were the bullies on Broad Street. If you like that crowd, you might like this crew as well.
First Washington turnover of the night. Each team has turned it over once. Graham brought his 16th career interception back 14 yards. Kenyon Barner let go by Philadelphia, went to the Chargers, didn't make their team, and The Eagles brought him back. He's been helpful in a limited role. Kevin O'Connell, the quarterback coach there with Kirk Cousins, explaining what happened was Kirk on that interception. Wentz looking up at the clock. Number one team in the league in time of possession will use as much clock as it can with 8 minutes to go, leading by 14.
And it's going to be LeGarrette Blount time.
Here comes the hammer to the 19-yard line.
A couple weeks ago, they got the ball with 6 minutes and 44 seconds left. Playing the L.A. Chargers, up by two. Peterson gave the ball to Blount repeatedly and ended that game. San Diego never saw the ball again. When you have a hammer like this, you swing it. Third down is short. Use all the clock and swing the anvil again.
Last three with the Patriots. Blount won two Super Bowls there. That surprising little interest when he was on the free agent market. Didn't sign till late May. Got a 1-year deal for just a little over $1 million. They knew he was getting it. Ryan Kerrigan almost beat the handoff to LeGarrette Blount.
There's one way to stop it. You bring an all-out blitz. Kerrigan. Not even blocked.
Here's a huge field goal try upcoming now for the rookie Jake Elliott. Make it a 3-score game if he can punch this one through from about 41 yards. 1-for-1 tonight. He's 13 out of 15 with the Eagles. Caleb Sturgis was their kicker, injured in the opener. Elliott was on the Bengals practice squad. Philadelphia plucked him away, and Jake Elliott became an immediate fan favorite. And that won't change as he's good from 42. 34-17 for Wentz and the Eagles with 6:19 to go.
An Emmy for that, John. That was pretty impressive voiceover, wasn't it?
Kirk Cousins and Washington in a heap of trouble. Down now 34-17 with 6:19 to go.
I've seen you do better work than that, John.
Yeah, it's not my finest. I think we might have to try to do that again. Couldn't tell that was on tape. We'll take a shot at it again this week. The Walter Payton Man of the Year Award presented by Nationwide recognizes NFL players for their excellence on and off the field. How about Torrey Smith of the Eagles, 3-time nominee when he was with other teams? He spent his life as an adult making a positive impact from coast to coast. Baltimore started the Torrey Smith Fund, set up leadership programs and scholarships for teens in the Bay Area, supported a shelter for mothers struggling with addiction. 2016 offseason, used his time and resources to help those impacted by the contaminated water supply in Flint, Michigan. Congratulations to Torrey Smith, one of the really good guys in the league. Terrell Pryor couldn't hang on and took a pretty good hit on first down.
I like what you just showed there on Torrey Smith.
Super guy.
I mean, he has had a difficult upbringing in a lot of ways, and man, he's a world champion, Baltimore Raven, played in San Francisco, has come over here, hasn't caught a lot of passes yet, but he sure has added a lot to this program.
Rob Kelly, the ball carrier. And Torrey Smith, the eldest of seven children. He's born to a 16-year-old single mother. And he was really the man of the household. His mother was out working a couple of jobs to earn an income. And he, as a very young man, was the man of the household.
Real credit to him.
Third down and four. Clinging to hope, the Redskins, and ooh, those hopes still alive for the moment by a pass interference flag against the Philadelphia Eagles.
They got Jalen Mills, number 31, at left corner.
Pass interference defense, number 31. Ball is placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Washington is, I think, fortunate here. Cousins thought Doxson was going to take it up. And Trent Williams walks off the field. That'll probably be the end of the All-Pro left tackle tonight. Redskins are going to have to get on an airplane potentially without Sheriff and Williams. Doesn't get much harder than that. And these young receivers just hasn't been good enough.
Cousins fires about an 8-yard gain to Jordan Reed. That was just the penalty on the previous play. Was just the second accepted penalty this half after there were 12 in the first half. Far fewer flags since the break. Second and one. Cousins screen for Rob Kelly. Chase Roullier, the backup guard, in there trying to lead the way. It's a first down for Washington, and they'll go quickly with the line of scrimmage, the Philadelphia 42.
Nice play by Chris Long recognizing that screen. Here's a man that's used to playing 62, 63 snaps a game. Now he's playing 22 or 23. And at first, I don't think he liked it. But now he's bought into the role he has, and he's going to be effective down the stretch here.
Here's Pryor running out of bounds. Very near the marker. Not sure if he got it. If he didn't, that's another mistake. There wasn't a lot of traffic along that sideline.
You know, this pass rush, these guys are all first and second rounders, Sean. And they have a lot of money invested in this defensive line. $160 million of cap space. And the vast majority of these men are all first and second rounders. Advantage Eagles in this situation.
Six of the seven in that rotation picked in the first two rounds. Rob Kelly, the catch. That was on second in about a foot, so that gets the first down. So they're going to talk about it on SportsCenter after the game tonight. Which is the best team in the NFC? Hard to argue with the Eagles right now being the choice.
Hard to argue that. Hard to argue that Carson Wentz isn't the best quarterback we've seen this year either.
Wentz now leading the league in touchdown passes with four tonight. He has 17 for the year. Jordan Reed, the catch.
Only enemy is the clock now. Fletcher Cox has just checked back in, and he'll work against the rookie Roullier at right guard.
Timeout called by the Eagles with the Redskins on the move, 3:52 to go. Up next Monday night at 8:15, the Broncos and the Chiefs. Kirk Cousins on second and four. Complete to Ryan Grant. He's down inbounds with a first down at the 12-yard line. The Redskins on the move, but running out of time, down by 17.
I like Ryan Grant. I think you're going to see a lot more of Ryan Grant the rest of this season. He's a young receiver that comes to play every week, and he's productive.
10-yard gain, six straight completions for Kirk Cousins. Coming up on 300 yards for the night. He's at 294. He fires one for Reed, who lunges into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington.
This man is so talented. He is special when he's healthy. Slant route. And Kirk Cousins unloaded that ball from the gun quickly and accurately. Says a lot about Kirk Cousins, the way he competes.
One of the questions about him when he came out of Michigan State was arm strength. He has plenty of zip on the ball. Two touchdown catches tonight for Jordan Reed, his first two of the season. And now Nick Rose, the 21st kicker for Washington in the last 23 years. Adds the extra point. That is far and away the most kickers used by any franchise in the league over that time.
Let's see if Nick Rose can execute an onside kick.
10-point game. Washington does have all three timeouts left, but you'd have to think with only 3:17 to go, the onside kick is the play. It's been a fun weekend for our crew here in the Philadelphia area. John got a chance on Saturday to have lunch with three South New Jersey high school teams nearby Cherry Hill. Lenape, Vineland, and Penn Saucon visited with the coach.
They can't hang with us. We're the best team. Can we hit the bell light? 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 Can we hit the bell light?
I love young people that play football. The game's taking a lot of hits out there, but keep playing. It's the greatest game. These guys from Pennsauken and Lenape and Vineland, what a blast we had.
You had all of them do their chants. You brought all of them onto the Monday Night Football bus. You really gave those kids a great day. And the schools made generous donations to each of those schools' football programs. And from what I told you, even gave a gift certificate to the coaches to take their significant others out for a dinner.
Well, we gave all three coaches a $100 gift certificate. Buy yourself a meal. You don't remember, maybe, we get too old and too involved, what these high school teachers and coaches have done for our young people. And especially football coaches. Every year they get paid less, and people expect more from them. It was a great time. I'm going to take you with me next time.
I was going to say, it's nice
to know
you bought somebody dinner. I've only been here for a year and a half, so I'm not that anxious, but that'll happen eventually, I'm sure.
But you get into South Jersey, there's a lot of good football players. Pennsauken High School is where John Taylor, the ex-49er wide receiver, played.
So we'll see if Rose is adept at the onside kick. First game in the NFL for the kicker out of the University of Texas. And recovered easily by Zach Ertz at the 50-yard line.
Well, Nick Rose is going to need a little more creativity on his onside kick, but he just got to D.C.
Mm-hmm.
And Jay Gruden with a very tough schedule. Dallas coming to town, upcoming games at Seattle, Minnesota Vikings. Already two Monday night road games and a lot of injuries.
And Dallas will have Ezekiel Elliott. He will be eligible at least for that game in week 8. Between the Redskins and the Cowboys, they're 3-3 after their big win against San Francisco. It's a tough upcoming schedule for Washington. And they'll take it on with some key injuries. Ooh. Oh, wow. Corey Clement, the rookie, almost committed a critical mistake. And as we mentioned earlier, the Eagles have the third easiest remaining schedule in the league. They still have two more home games in a row. And the winless 49ers come here next. They haven't won a game, but they've been tough. Yesterday was the exception. Their route at the hands of Dallas. They've been in most of the games they've played this year, the Niners.
Certainly have. Dallas still loaded on offense, and if that young defense can come around, the defending Eastern champs are a handful. And you see who just checked back in the game, LeGarrette Blount. Clement, who just fumbled that exchange over there on the sideline with Deuce Staley, the former Eagle running back, getting an earful.
Two timeouts left for Washington. With 3:11 to go.
Look out.
LeGarrette Blount finally breaks free. His long run of the night had been 5 yards prior to that carry. The rookie safety out of Michigan State, Monte Nicholson, took him down. First down to the Washington 33.
Just let it run full speed. This is a 255-pound freight train. You get tired of seeing Blount. He has 8 carries for no yards. You think you've got him all bottled up, and then he busts one. Big, strong, elusive back.
And a 21-yard gain gives him 23 yards rushing for the night on 11 carries. At age 30, trying to prove he still has plenty left in the tank after he had his career best season a year ago in New England when he rushed for more than 1,100 yards. Junior Gallette made the tackle on that play. And it looks like Jay Gruden is going to let it go down to the 2-minute warning.
Jay Gruden is going to hope that he gets Sheriff and Trent Williams and Josh Norman and some of his horses back next week because they're going to need him.
2-minute warning, Monday Night Football from Philadelphia.
Announcing the 10 for 10.
Carson Wentz's night. It's been his season. His Philadelphia Eagles about to go to league best 6-1. Every other team in the league has at least 2 losses. That was the play of the night. On a critical third down with momentum on Washington's side, a 7-point game. He ran 17 yards for a first down on 3rd and 8. When it seemed certain he was going to get sacked, they marched down the field and scored. Huge game-changing play. 2 minute warning, two timeouts for the Redskins, down by 10. They come on a blitz. They stop Blunt short of the first down by about 2.5 yards. Four touchdown passes, a career high, 64 rushing yards, a career high. He is the NFL leader by himself in touchdown passes with 17.
You know, the numbers are great. Everybody's gonna go crazy in the fantasy football world about Wentz, but when you look at the film or you go watch this man play, you don't realize how he did it.
Okay.
Unbelievable scrambling, pocket toughness, pinpoint passing, audibles. Those numbers don't even do this performance any justice.
He's in control of this offense. You mentioned they've given him much more flexibility at the line of scrimmage, and he is rewarding their faith. Blunt doing everything to escape, but he cannot. Again, good penetration by the Redskins, and they're battling all the way to the finish. Zach Brown finished off Blunt, and Washington used his last time out. Well, you've talked about Wentz, the person, man of tremendous faith, his character. If you watched ESPN this weekend, you probably saw Tom Rinaldi's piece about Lucas Custer's 10-year-old from nearby Wilmington, Delaware, who lost a year-long battle with cancer over the summer. He had a visit from Carson Wentz. Actually, Carson Wentz had sent him a video wishing him well. The Custer's family here on the field before the game tonight. When it was obvious that Lucas was getting near the end, Make-A-Wish asked him, what do you want to do? He said, I want to thank Carson Wentz for reaching out to me. They wound up having an in-person visit. That field goal is off the upright. He's a tremendous young man. Says his faith is the most important thing in his life, and he's one of those people who lives it. You know, when you are around him, you can feel the inherent goodness that he has coming from his faith.
It's unbelievable. He thinks his Lord Jesus Christ helps him play better, gives him more confidence. It allows him to cut things loose. He has really done an unbelievable job at North Dakota State. He ran his own Bible study. He's doing that here in Philadelphia. He doesn't push it down anybody's throat, but good for him. He is a great person that has made a huge impact on and off the field. And if you're into good stories, follow this man around.
Well, the family told the story. They were blown away when they saw Carson Wentz wearing that green bracelet. It says Dutch Destroyer. That was Lucas Custer's nickname when he played youth football. He was a terrific 10-year-old football player, loved football. And obviously Carson's keeping in touch with the family. The young man was buried in a Carson Wentz jersey. Derek Barnett, the play for Philadelphia, second and 22. Second sack of the night for the rookie out of Tennessee. Green for Thompson, and they're ready for that now. It had been effective a couple of times here in the fourth quarter. Jalen Watkins, the play for the Eagles.
And you look at these Philadelphia Eagles in a prevent defense. Just look at them. They're all standing back near the 40-yard line. And they're just watching these four men in front of them go after the quarterback. And it's fun to watch these four pass rushers get off the ball.
Draw. Lots of running room for Thompson. A bad effort. He's still about 10 yards short of the first down. So 30 seconds to go. And the Redskins about to go down to defeat to go to 3-3. And Kirk Cousins will be 0-6 as a starter on Monday Night Football. Hard to blame him tonight. As usual, he has given it his all. He's thrown for 303 yards with a receiving core that is certainly below average by NFL standards. And he has good company at 0-6. The only other quarterbacks to go 0-6 on Monday Night Football lose their first six were Joe Namath and Archie Manning.
And Fran Tarkenton was 0-5, I think.
And wound up winning four Monday Night Football games. He's going to win some on Monday Night Football before he's done. Question down the road will be, will it be as a Redskin playing on the transition tag again this year? ESPN News is projecting Philadelphia as the winner of this game. And they'll go to 6-1. And the Redskins tied with the Cowboys.
Some kind of projection there.
Yeah, they're going out on a limb tonight.
win probability is extremely high and getting higher with each passing second. No more room left on the Wentz wagon here in Philadelphia. It is completely full. And give Doug Peterson, Frank Reich, John DeFilippo a lot of credit for the great coaching they've done with that young man. 10-point win for Philadelphia. We'll see you next week from Kansas City.
Coming up on SportsCenter, the Eagles' role in Philadelphia. Coming up, Louis Riddick on, is this the best team, not just in the NFC, but of all the NFL as well. We will show you Ben Simmons' very first ever triple-double. Joel Embiid's limited minutes did not mean limited production. And Katie Nolan makes her SportsCenter debut. She says that Steelers hide-and-seek celebration